Are you serious? Are you serious? President Donald Trump getting ready to speak to the entire world, really, but 54 leaders of the Arabic nations, Muslim nations of the world, 54 gathering in Saudi Arabia to hear what President Donald Trump has to say. Already, Trump is redoing the mess, really, that Obama left the Middle East in. Think it through. Saudi Arabia, he's went in, he's restored the relationship with Saudi Arabia. 54 Muslim nations are coming to hear what he has to say. And part of how he's restoring it is President Barack Obama and that nuclear deal he did with Iran completely messed up everything. What it did was it put the Saudi Arabians on high alert for fear they were going to be annihilated, as Iran right now is turning those centrifuges. And so it empowered Iran. Plus, he gave Iran tons of money in the middle of the night, which Iran's been using to fund the Houthi rebels that attacked Saudi Arabia from Yemen and overthrew the Yemen government. They fund Hamas, who fires rockets at Israel. Iran funds Hezbollah, who threatens Israel from the north. Iran is sitting on the doorstep now of Israel and has said they want to annihilate Israel and annihilate Saudi Arabia. So Trump comes in. He's redoing everything that Obama messed up. He's trying to show respect to the Muslim people. Yet in his speech, he is going to call out Islamist extremism. He's going to go after ISIS. He wants to unite the Muslim world to come against ISIS and radical, you know, Islamic extremism. I mean, radical Islam, basically. ISIS, terrorism. So he'll address that while unifying. Now, that then, after he's done with this visit, he will then go to, oh, and by the way, sell some arms to both the Saudis and the Kuwaitis so they can protect themselves from Iran, who threatened both of them. Then he'll go to Jerusalem to refix the bridges that Obama tore down there and try to reestablish a great relationship with the Jews in the nation of Israel. And even talk of a peace with the Palestinians, he'll even see President Abbas in Bethlehem. And he may even go to the Wailing Wall and pray. Now, he's not going to move the U.S. Embassy yet. He said, not yet, but I will. And then from there, he goes to Rome to meet the Pope and a cordial visit to reestablish the fact that he was going to the Middle East to meet with the three major religions of the apocalypse: Muslims, Jews, and Christians. Then from there, it's to Europe, to NATO, to talk with the NATO leaders, to put a strategically strength for the Western world, including Europe, and then the G7 summit to talk economy with the world economy. So this is an unbelievable trip. Unbelievable. He's going to have a little bit of optics. He looked terrible dancing with the sword with the Saudis. I mean, he's not in step with that. But just showing respect in ceremonies, but trying to figure out a way to get everybody at peace, mainly how to protect Israel in the midst of this Middle East and put down this Arab Spring madness and the crisis with ISIS. I'll be back with more current world events. Pray for the president. I don't agree with everything. None of us do. You can't agree with just everything. But certainly what he is undoing, the mess that Obama put the world in, the chaos. I'll be back with more in just a moment. Give your life to Jesus Christ. He's coming. By all of this, you can tell he's coming soon.